Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. SpaceX posted a couple of super cool pictures on Twitter of the team and a Raptor engine outside their Hawthorne factory. They captioned a tweet with 100th build of a Raptor engine complete. It's absolutely incredible that they are now at a point of having built their 100th Raptor engine. Bloomberg posted an article saying the Federal Communications Commission is challenging a bid by Elon Musk's SpaceX for $886 million in rural broadband subsidies, saying some of the money appeared headed for serving parking lots and airports with satellite-delivered broadband. Over in Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital tank farmer's work continues. There is also work continuing on the orbital launch mount. Here is the ninth level of the integration tower being constructed. There are a load of cryo tank shells as construction continues there too. SpaceXers have been doing brickwork at the back of the mid bay recently. There was a road closure posted for today for some rollouts, and this tweet was also posted. So the orbital launch table was captured being rolled out today, and as well as rolling out this orbital launch table, they also rolled out the GSE-5 tank. I know a bunch of you wanted some more information about the new higher high bay, and there is now some more information. Marcus House captioned Elon Musk's tweet about building the larger high bay and said, "A lot of speculation on how big this will be, but let me just say one thing. No amount of bigness will satisfy the dreams of Elon. This will be a small step towards the next largest bay." Elon Musk responded and said, "Only a little taller but much bigger base and two gantry cranes that run full span." There was recently a plane that flew over Starbase and released pesticide to tackle a mosquito problem. La Padre posted a video on Twitter of this plane flying over the launch site. Musk responded and said, "Seriously, we are getting eaten alive. Can't get to Mars if the bugs eat us first." This nose cone barrel section was seen being prepared for heat shield tile installation. Plus, there is a Starship nose being prepared for tile installation too. On the right here, you can see GSE-5 being worked on and more GSE tanks on the left. The ground support equipment tank GSE-6 was rolled out of the high bay too. Here's the latest with the construction of Ship 20, which will fly to orbit atop Booster 4. This aft section for the Booster 4 prototype was spotted outside the high bay. Booster 4 was also spotted being stacked. I wanted to share some exciting information posted about Booster 4 and Ship 20 on the NASA spaceflight forums. It says sources close to SpaceX have indicated that Elon ordered several hundred Hawthorne and Florida employees to temporarily relocate to Starbase in an effort to get Booster 4 and Ship 20 completed on the orbital platform by August 5th. In addition, they also seek to have enough capacity in the GSE suborbital and orbital combined for the Booster 4 and Ship 20 tests. The activity of Booster 3 was stopped and will stay that way. As always, I have to thank Mary or Boca Chica Gal, who is always out in Boca Chica filming the amazing content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their great videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.